Hey VC, how's it going? Right, okay, last weekend I met up with a bunch of the guys up at Leeds Record Fair. So yeah, there's a number of people who make VC videos and a few that don't, but you know, people that comment and watch videos joined us as well. And it was a really good day. So, you know, we spent a morning at the record fair. We went for a few beers in a local pub and then onto a couple of record shops, which is really cool. So, but I've taken some footage and some photographs, and which I'll cut in a moment. But first up, some VCLT. This was from Martin Parrott. I don't know if you can see that very well. This is a compilation mix CD that he put together. As you can see, the artwork is based around the Who Lies Live at Leeds album. So this is the Vinyl Community Live at Leeds. And it's just, I say, a mix CD full of absolute randomness. And it's brilliant. It's great. It's so entertaining. I didn't know much that was on here. So, you know, all week when I've been playing it, my ears have pricked up at certain times trying to work out what the tune was. But very cool, Martin. That was very nice. And Martin also gave me a 45, an African 45 by a band called The Five Boys on the Malelo label, which is also really nice. So thanks very much, Martin. Also, Flip Disc Mark. Now, Mark doesn't make videos, but he does comment regularly and watch videos. He gave me a couple of CDs, which are very cool. These are Mystic Brew compilations on Fat City Records. I think these must have come out in the late 90s. So it's a mixture of 90s hip hop, old school reggae, bits of quirky soul. But yeah, these are both very nice. So I played those quite a bit this week. So thanks for that, Mark. Right. So I'm going to show the footage that I took the wrong way around. We started off in the record fair, but I'm going to start off by showing some footage of one of the record shops called Crash Records. I really like this shop. Upstairs, it's new stuff. Downstairs, it's all secondhand. It's all used. And you'll see from the bits of footage that I've taken that it's quite small. It's quite compact. A shitload of records in there. Fantastic. Love it. The smell, you know, the aroma, it smells of... those heavy duty PVC sleeves, you know, so that's the smell that hits you when you walk in there. But yeah, very cool. Now I picked up this record from Crash Records. This is Bobby Taylor and the Vancouvers. It's on the Gaudy label, so it's a Motown release. This is an original US copy and it's absolutely pristine. Beautiful. I've been looking for a UK copy for years on Tamla Motown, but it goes for decent money and it's normally a little bit grubby, but this is pristine. Motown records from this sort of period can often be a bit hit and miss, you know, one side of good original tunes and the second side can be, you know, littered with show tune covers and stuff like that. But this is great from start to finish and I definitely recommend that.
Yeah.
Good
So, yeah, I'll see you next year, Henley, if you ever get out.
Right, so before going to the record shop, so we were at the record fair and I was really impressed with the record fair. It's in a market, an indoor market, and it's split across two halls. You'll see a little bit of the footage in a moment. And yeah, loads of choice, loads of good records there. I thought the prices were pretty good. For example, this is the first thing that I picked up. This is Funkadelic with Tales of Kid Funkadelic. I don't think this is a first press. I'll need to check it out, but I think it's like an early press, probably the same year of the original release. On West Brown Records, came out in 76. I've had a reissue of this for years, but I haven't played it too much. And the reason being is it's quite an uneven record. So I understand that this is made up of outtakes or, you know, offcuts from previous Funkadelic records. So it's just a bit of a mop up, really. But the first side is great. It's full on P-Funk. A really good record. The second side is mostly taken up with a 12-minute instrumental synth improvisation, which is all right once or twice, but it's not something you want to listen to again and again, which is perhaps the reason why I haven't played this one as much. But this is a lovely copy. I'll just get rid of my my reissue or flip that. But yeah, really pleased to find out. And for 12 quid, you can't go wrong with that. And I also picked up this album by the Abyssinians. It's called Arise. This came out in 78 on the Virgin Frontline label. Now, the Abyssinians, beautiful vocal harmonies. It's late 70s, roots reggae. Their debut album is wonderful, and this pretty much just carries off where that left off. Yeah, a lovely record. I don't think they made anything else after this album. I think they split up shortly after. I think I'm right in saying that. Unless they've done something much later on, but I think it was just these two albums I put out in the late 70s. And so this is on the Frontline label, so because obviously it's part of Virgin, these records you can pretty much get quite easily over here in the UK. You know, on the Frontline label, we had the likes of the Abyssinians, the Gladiators, Tapazuki, Prince Farai. So you can get these records about now and again. So, and I say, once I see them, I tend to pick them up. So yeah, a lovely record. Really enjoyed that. Couple of records from the fair. This is a big one for me. This is the one that I spent the most money on. This is a self-titled Link Ray album. As you can see, it's got the die-cut sleeve there. I think this is 71, and it's a bit of a country funk classic. So I first became aware of this album perhaps in the 2000s, when the Light in the Attic compilation Country Funk came out, the first volume of that. The track Fire and Brimstone features on that compilation. So I've been looking for this since then, and I've never seen it. I mean, I'm pretty sure I could have got it online, but, you know, wouldn't have been out and about at fairs or record shops. I've never seen a copy, so I did pay up a bit for this, but I was pleased with what I paid. Really nice copy, and they say this is a UK press on Polydor. Very nice. And from the same seller, I also picked up this Ray Barretto compilation, mid-60s. It's on the Tico label. It's typical sort of Latin groove stuff. Really nice, pristine again. You can see about their original 1965 copy, looking gorgeous. And yeah, I played this quite a bit. The main reason I picked it up is because of the opening track, El Watusi, which is the one track on here that I did know beforehand, and it's a real groover. Yeah, so really nice stuff, and pleased for what I paid for this as well, so that's quite cool. So yeah, so there you go. That was our meetup in Leeds. Great to see everyone. A right good laugh. We had a few beers on the afternoon. I must admit, once we got in the pub, I could quite easily have stayed there, but I'm pleased that people talked me around and we ended up going to some record shops, which was cool. So there you go. Some really nice records. Pleased what I picked up, and great to see everyone. Cheers. Jesucristo, 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 yo estoy aquí.